Hello everyone, Christina here. It has been a crazy morning. Sorry, I have no makeup on. All I do is my hair again. Maybe this is my new MO every time I go live on Fridays. It's just crazy. A few announcements before we get into today's project. The first thing I want to let you know about is we have a brand new class just announced like an hour and a half ago, which is why it's been a crazy morning. We have a brand new class at onlinecardclasses.com called Stenciled 2. It's all about, you know, using stencils and being creative with stencils. So please come and join us. There's a link down below in the video description. There is an early bird discount code that will be automatically applied when you register for the class through the 7th, I think, at midnight. So after that, the price will go back to the regular price. So if you want to sign up for class starts on the 13th. It's me and Jennifer McGuire and a bunch of amazing guest artists. And we're going to be sharing with you some fun stenciling techniques. If you'd like to join us, go ahead and go to that link down in the video description. So the other announcements, I'm not going to put this in the edited replay. So I'm going to act like I'm not. Okay. All right. So there's a giveaway for today's live viewers again. This giveaway is going to be a prize pack of Mama Elephant stamps and dies. I've set them aside. They are mostly things that have come out in the last few months. So today I'm going to be using a specific Mama Elephant stamp and die, and I will include that in the giveaway package. So for those of you who are watching live right now at this moment, go to the link in the video description to fill out that form. All you have to do is put in your name and email address so that I have some way to contact you should your name be drawn as the winner. And I'm going to draw the winner at the end of today's live stream after I'm done creating my card. So hopefully that'll be a fun little thing for all of you watching live. But for those who are not watching live, they missed out. They should have joined us. And I'm hoping I can do more of these giveaways every week during live streams. Part of kind of like my, I'm changing how I do things in my craft room in order to keep things more organized and just, you know, make sure I'm not stashing away things that I don't really want to keep or don't need to keep. One of the things I'm doing is I want to do more giveaways as, you know, as I move along. Instead of waiting and doing big giveaway, like lots of giveaways all at once, I want to do smaller giveaways throughout the months. So here we are. We're going to do a giveaway with some really fun Mama Elephant stuff. Now, if you know me, most of the time, okay, so I've got my regular crafting collection, right? So like things that I use in my everyday videos. And then I've got like my personal, I'm going to hoard these items until the day I die collection. And a lot of those are from Mama Elephant. I love them so much. I love the really cute images and they have great greetings and they're just so creative over there. I love Mama Elephant. So I'm happy to use some stamps and dies from them. So here we go. Now I'm editing Christina. This is where you edit out that portion of the giveaway. And we're going to start talking to everyone again. We're not just talking to the live people anymore. The other announcement is that I'm going to have mail call, the mail call video, like the wrap up for February will be next week. My husband went to my UPS box today, or not today, it was like 2 days ago, and picked up a bunch of stuff that you guys have mailed in for mail call. So I wanted to wait until the end of February until everything had arrived before I start filming that. So even if it hasn't quite arrived yet, I think I'm going to go pick up one more batch of envelopes at my mailbox. I'm going to pick that up probably tomorrow and then I'll film next week. So if you want to participate in mail call, the February theme is probably a little bit too late, but you can definitely get in on the March theme, which I don't even remember what it is right now, but I'm sure it's fun. And so send in those cards for mail call. So today's card is going to be featuring, let me switch to my overhead. It's featuring these really cute stamps from Mama Elephant. Let me put a piece of cardstock behind this so you can see. How cute are these? I love their animals. And normally they're really, really small. And these are really, really big. So this is going to be great for painting or coloring or anything like that. I thought I would do some watercoloring today. I haven't watercolored for a while. So I thought I'd do some watercoloring. And I love how they're kind of, they're a little bit size proportion correct, right? like a baby elephant with a little bear, a fox. The cat is like itty bitty. So is the bunny. So cute. For those wondering about the giveaway, you have to go to the link down below in the video description. It just says enter the giveaway. And then I've got the coordinating dies that go with. It looks like it cuts out this little bird, it cuts out the whole group, and it also cuts out the huge hugs greetings. So I'm gonna be using, I don't know if I'll use the little bird today, but you know, maybe I'll paint it just in case I want to. So we're gonna start out by stamping this onto some watercolor paper. So I've got some, that one's dirty. There's stuff on it. We're not gonna use that one. We're gonna use this other sheet of Fabriano Artistico Extra White. And I'm gonna stamp my cute little images first before we get going. Hello to everyone in the chat. Welcome, welcome. I see lots of familiar faces. Thanks for joining me. Just making sure I'm stamping on the correct side. Watercolor paper does have a slightly different texture. Yeah, that's the right side. Okay. Front versus back. The giveaway today is a prize pack of Mom Elephant stamps and dies. So I hope you guys will join in. Alrighty, we're gonna put those cute little animals there. And we'll do this little bird up here just in case I want to use it. I don't know if I will or not, but oh, and I'm going to put my watch on do not disturb. My watch and my phone. I forgot to do that before going live. So here we are. Okay, because I'm watercoloring, I'm going to use a waterproof ink. And the waterproof ink that I use the most is Versafine Onyx Black. So I'm gonna use that today. I considered doing some no-line watercoloring, but this is such a large image that I knew I would spend ages on it if I did no-line watercoloring. So if I ever do no-line watercoloring on a big image like this, I will most likely not have it be in a live video because that would just take too long and I don't wanna make you guys sit through that. So, although it is pretty relaxing to watch. Someone in the chat asks, do you have a preference in watercolor paper? The weight, hot press, cold press, etc. My go-to watercolor paper, I'm going to stamp this again so I can get a really good impression. My go-to watercolor paper is the one I'm using today, which is Fabriano Artistico Extra White. I use that more than anything right now. But for other uses or other cases, I might want to use a different watercolor paper. Let's see, it looks like just these little areas are right in the center need a little more inking. For other uses, like if I'm doing just some really simple watercolor backgrounds, or if I don't need to add a ton of water or whatever, I also really like Canson XL. I think that's a really great budget-friendly alternative, you know, and it's still a really great watercolor paper. I've also recently started using Altenew watercolor paper, which they say is a cold press, but it really is almost like more of a hot press because it's a little bit on the thinner side and it's more smooth. So if any of you want to try out Altenew watercolor paper, in fact, I'm almost tempted to go grab some of that and use that for this today. No, we'll just go with what I've got going here. Okay. And as per usual, I did not get my stamp chamois wet, so we're using baby wipes to clean off my stamps. I hope all of you guys go sign up for our class over OCC. I'm excited about it. We've been planning this class since, oh gosh, December? It's taken that long for us to get all of our ducks in a row. And Jennifer and I were texting the other day, and we're like, how in the world did we do so many classes years ago? We would do class after class after class. And now it's like, it just takes so long to get a class organized and together, you know, like it takes forever. But we've had this planned for a long time. So we're excited to finally, you know, open registration and get things going. Okay. Oh, good, Mel. Budget friendly. Yeah. Go for Canson XL. And that's a really good one. Kind of an all-purpose one, I think. Question. I know you mentioned having a special food bowl for your cat since you have them separately. Do you happen to know where the bowls are available? It's SureFeed Pet Feeders. And you have to buy the units. And then you can buy the individual bowls that go into the unit. You can buy some more bowls for that. But it's just look up like SurePet Feeders. I think that's what it is. All right. Let's get to some watercolor painting. Now, I am not planning to paint the background around the animals. I'm going to die cut them. So I'm not going to bother taping this to a board. Normally, I would only tape things to a board if I'm going to be painting really, really large areas with lots and lots of water and paint. But today I'm going to be painting smaller areas. And I'll be die cutting it anyway. So running through the die cutting machine will kind of flatten out any, you know, warping that might happen. Lynn asks, what is your current class offering in OCC? You're asking about the classes. It's stenciled two. Starts in like a week and a few days. All right, today I'm going to be using distress inks and all of the original 60 fit in this little tray from Stampin' Storage. I do have the newer ones that are set aside, but they're not convenient to pick up like this. So we're going to be using the original colors, which is nice, you know, because I know them pretty well. And we're going to be smushing those onto a palette and then painting. And I love to use distress inks and distress colors for painting little critters like this because I don't know. I know the colors really well and it works out. Okay. We're going to do this so I can. All right. And I might have to do some Googling to get some like colors for the animals, but I do think like a pale purple for the elephant would be really, really cute. So I think we'll go with shaded lilac and dusty concord. I think those would be great. Hold on, I need to get a paper towel. Get a paper towel going. Just to have this ready. Ruth asks, how does the giveaway work? Is it international? Yes, it's international. Just whoever I pick at the end of the live stream, I'll just, hopefully they'll still be in the chat here, still watching. And I'll email them and get their address and mail them out. That's how it works. Brushes. Yes, Royal Langnickel, the one I'm going to use today. I'm using a Royal Langnickel Zen brush in the size 2. These are really great brushes to use for painting smaller images like this, like the size 2 in particular. All right, I'm going to start with shaded lilac. And I'm just smushing it on my palette here. And then I'm going to pick up the color from the palette. And we're going to start with that cute little elephant. All right, so I'm just getting a, you know what? This is like sliding around. And it's going to annoy me. So I'm just going to put some tape underneath the palette. And then it won't move around too much. There we go. Ah, much better. All right. So I'm just going to come in. And I mostly just want like a nice wash of color over the entire elephant. And then I'm going to come in with the dusty concord and add some shading. In fact, I'm tempted to bring in sealess preserves instead. We'll see. The other thing you could do when you do like a initial wash of color over an animal or over even like a person or anything like that is you can also have a little bit of pink ready to go. And you can drop in the blush on their cheeks. So I'm going to grab a little bit of warm lipstick. That's my go-to for little cheeks. And while that's still wet, I'm just going to bring in a little bit of that pink right here. Hopefully I can get that like wicking away a little bit. And just soften it. Yeah, just like that. Add a little bit more in. I want just a little bit more intensity. Cleaning off my brush and then kind of softening those edges. Oh, the mail call for March is stencils. That's perfect. I didn't even plan that. That's great. All right, I'm also going to take a little bit of the pink. I think I'm just going to do the inside of his ear. I think that works well too, just to give it a little bit of color. All right. I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit of the coloring on the fox because it's not touching anything on the elephant. And I'm going to use, spiced marmalade for the initial layer on the fox. And then I'll come in with rusty hinge for the shading. So I'm watering down, in case you can't see it, it's off screen, but I'm watering down the rusty hinge or the spiced marmalade pretty well. And then I'm just going to come in and get the initial coloring on our little fox. He's so cute. They're all hugging each other. It's so dang adorable. Okay. All right, we're gonna do this bunny, my favorite bunny color, which is scattered straw. I just think it's the most perfect, like, pale yellow shade. That one is kind of touching the elephant just a tiny bit, but looks like we're okay. Pick up a little bit of that worn lipstick. Put a little pink right on him. All right, penguin. We're doing traditional penguin color. So we'll start with hickory smoke and do shading with black soot. So here's hickory smoke. And his little arms will be gray. And then the upper portion of his head. Oh, he's gonna be cute. All right, the bear, I'm gonna go for like a traditional brown. So let's start him out with, I'm tempted to start him out with like a lighter gold shade, but maybe we'll just go straight into vintage photo. Yeah, we'll do vintage photo and then eventually darken it up with ground espresso. Oh, I just flicked some water. Thankfully it went on the outside of the image. Okay, I'm watering down the vintage photo quite a bit. And then I'm just gonna start to come in. Maybe I need to water it down even more. Get his little tummy. And his hand. Everything right up to the little mouse. So I'm just doing really simple watercoloring today. I think I'm mostly just going to do like a flat wash of color and then bring in just a line of shadow. you know, around each image, just to keep it really, really simple. The distress ink tray that I'm using is from Stampin' Storage. It's they have these plastic inserts for their drawer units, and that's what that is. Okay, and then the last one to get an initial coloring is gonna be this little kitty. And of course I'm gonna make the kitty look like my cats. So we're going back to the hickory smoke. And we'll just do a really light gray, mostly around the top part of the face and the arms. I'm gonna keep the belly white because my kitties have white tummies with little spots on them, but this is a pretty small image. I don't think I'm gonna have room for all the spots. All right, but I can take a little bit of that worn lipstick, add a little bit of pink, and a little kitty. Oh, I forgot to add the pink on the bear. Add that in now. It looks like it's starting to dry, but I think I'll be okay. I'm going to bring in some of the worn lipstick. I'm just going to add that right on his cheeks. I'm going to clean off my brush, mostly dry it, and I'm going to try to kind of massage those edges. And that will soften the color and help it blend with the brown. And hopefully I won't get a wet water spot from it. Okay. Someone's saying not the penguin's arm. What are you saying? That's the penguin's arm. Oh, it's the bear's arm. You were very correct. It looks like it could be the penguin's arm. You know, it could totally be the penguin's arm, but here, let's put a little water on it and see if I can pick up that color. The good thing with distress inks is you can usually pick up color pretty well. Oh well, it might just be the penguin's arm. We'll add a little brown and see what we can do. Ooh, that may have been a bad choice. It's the bear's hand in shadow, right? Too funny. All right, we need the little bird up at the top. I'm gonna come in with mustard seed for that one. It'll be a bright yellow, but we'll add some other colors on it later to kind of soften it. Okay, let's see here. The mouse, well, he could be really whatever color he wants. I'm thinking maybe we'll have him be gray as well. So I'm coming in with more of that hickory smoke. I'm also going to take a little bit of that hickory smoke and just shade the bunny's tail just a little bit right there. And while I'm at it, I'm going to take that worn lipstick and get the bunny's ears. Not being very precise. Slow down, Christina. Okay. So the fox's tail, the bits that are white, I'm going to take that hickory smoke and I'm going to add some shading where there would be shadow. Because I've got his face finished, I can come in and do a little bit of where that worn lipstick would be. I think it would probably be about right there. I don't know. That might not be quite right, but that's okay. I'm gonna do a little bit of the hickory smoke on the ear right there. And then also the hand. I'm running out of color. Let's get more hickory smoke. A little bit of that shadow right there.
soften that out. Okay, the penguin also is going to have shadow with, you know, over the white areas. So I'm just going to add that in right now. A little bit of shading around his head. I'll bring in that worn lipstick for his little cheeks. Okay. A little bit of the worn lipstick on the cat's ear. And I think I'm about ready to hit this with my heat tool to dry so I can start adding in all those shadow areas. All right, so I'm gonna hold this up away from my work surface and dry this. I've decided I'm not gonna use that bird. Now that I'm looking at this watercolor paper, I totally stamped on the wrong side. Oh well. Okay, everything's looking dry. One little drop of water off to the side that wasn't, but that's okay. All right, so now I'm gonna come in with some darker shades to add shadow. So for the fox, I'm using Rusty Hinge. Kind of like a dark brownish orange. I think it's going to be perfect. And then as I add the shadow in, I then clean off my brush and then I can just sort of soften it so that it blends in a little bit more with the shade underneath. Just like dabbing off my brush and then coming in and almost like massage or scrub the area. Let me zoom in here. There we go. All right, I'm gonna bring this color in a little bit more because I like how intense that shadow is up there. I just want to get the rest of it like that too. All right, so we'll have a little shadow right there and right down the side. Cleaning off my brush and then coming in and sort of scrubbing those areas to try to get it to blend a little bit. That seems to work for me when I do that. Okay. Grabbing more of that Rusty Hinge. And I'm going to come into this area. Clean off my brush. And then come in and just kind of scrub it in so that I'm gonna clean up my brush one more time. Just like that. I actually like this harsh edge I'm getting right here. I think it looks really great. So I'm just gonna leave that there. But I do wanna add a little more shading on his back. Not a ton, just a little bit. There we go. Because I did want the shadow over on this side, so it kind of makes more sense that there'd be some intense shadow right there as well. Oh, that's so cute. All right. I'm going to use, I'm going to grab the ground espresso. I'm actually going to be using it on the bear as well. So I'm just grabbing some ground espresso. And I'm going to use that on the fox's ear on the inside. Might as well come over and get the bear's ear as well. Okay, now we're going to start shading the bear. So I'm going to do the same thing I did before. Let's start with the feet. I'm just going to add a little bit of shadow right there. Dip my brush in water, dab it off on a paper towel so it's not so wet. And then just come in and kind of massage that harsh edge. And that softens the edge and helps it kind of blend a little bit more. I'm going to dip my brush in clean water again, dab it off on my paper towel, and then come back in and massage that edge until it starts to blend a little bit. All right, going on to the other foot. I'm going to do the same thing. Clean off my brush, dab it on a paper towel. Kind of scrub my brush so it massages and blends. I'm cleaned off my brush again. There we go. All right, coming in with more shadow. So there would be a dark shadow underneath his head, right? Because his chin and everything is above. So I'm going to add that right there first. And then I've also got the areas that are like closest to the animals and the sides. So we'd also have shading right there. Come in and massage that out. This would be a really dark area right here. And also just the side of his tummy. All right, I'm gonna try to clean off my brush and kind of get this center area again. Get more ink. Okay, add that dark area down here. Clean off my brush, dab it on a paper towel, and come in and soften that edge. And clean off my brush again and soften that edge further. All right, I think I'm just gonna add a little more shadow right there. I feel like the mouse is kind of like right in front there. I feel like there'd just be a little more shadow. All right, for his head, here we go. There's a lot of shadow right in here because the penguin's right in front and there's also the hand of the fox. So we're gonna have quite a bit of shadow right there. Cleaning off my brush. Softening that shadow line. There's going to be quite a bit of shadow right here from the fox and also the little elephant. I'm mainly just keeping the centers of each kind of shape. I'm keeping those the lightest, if that makes sense. So this, the face of the bear is a really large shape. So it's going to have the lightest area in the center. Turn this a little bit, clean off my brush, soften that shadow line. I'm going to come in right here. Clean off my brush again. Soften the shadow line. All right, I feel like I need to add a little more shadow down through here. And I'm losing some of that worn lipstick, so I'm gonna bring that back in because I do want the little blush to show quite a bit. Bear's looking pretty cute. So let's see some shading. Let's see, I feel like I need more right in here. Like it kind of lightened. I was gonna move on to another animal, but I'm not done with the bear yet. I'm going to bring that like really dark, intense shadow in right there. Okay. That's looking a little better. Okay. Let's just go for the elephant. I'm using Dusty Concord for, I gotta clean off my palette first, hold on. Got too much color going. Okay. All right. Dusty Concord for the shading on the elephant. I know elephants really aren't purple, but I've seen enough in cartoons that I think a purple elephant is an acceptable color. All right, I'm going to bring in that shading just right there, and I'm going to blend it out and see, do I really want it as this color? I think I do. It kind of has a little bit of a pink glow to it, which I think is really, really pretty. So let's keep that. We're going to keep using Dusty Concord. So we'll bring that shadow in right there. Once again, kind of massage the color so that it blends. Then get the bottom of his trunk, and he's got a lot of shadow because it's right behind the bear's ear. So just like that. All right, we're gonna do some shadow right along this side. I'm gonna need a little more Dusty Concord. Smush that down. Okay, how fun would it be to paint all these animals in like really unrealistic colors? Like the bear could be blue. You know, wouldn't that be cute? All right, I'm gonna add a little shadow along this line here. Soften that edge, just like that. And then, let's see, I've gotta look at it right side up again. lots of shadow right in here. And then we'd have shadow coming behind the bunny's ears. I'm cleaning off my brush, dabbing on a paper towel, and then kind of scrubbing the area to try to get the colors to kind of fade out. All right, for those of you who are just joining me for the live, there is a giveaway for those who are watching live today. So make sure you go to the link down the video description and enter the giveaway. I'm gonna put just a little line of the dark color around the left side. You know, I have never really painted much with Dusty Concord or Shaded Lilac, but I'm in love with this because it's like, it looks like it's glowing. I feel like I need to put polka dots on the elephant. It can be a heffalump or something like that. Okay, for the bunny, actually, let's go to the mouse. I think that one will be a little bit easier to shade right now until the elephant dries. So I'm going in with black soot for the shading on the penguin and the mouse, actually. So let's start with the penguin. We're going to add just a little bit of shading like over by the bear and also just the top of his head. And then we can kind of clean up that area and soften it just like that. I'm gonna go ahead and grab, let's see, I think we could use carved pumpkin. No, ripe persimmon. I'm going to do a little bit of ripe persimmon just for, is it a beak on a penguin? I don't know. Its mouth? I have no idea. We're going to put a little bit of just orange right there. All right, back to the black soot. And I'm going to add a little bit of shading just around the outline of the mouse. And kind of get that blending out a little bit. Come back in and add it underneath his ears and just bottom of his head and around the ears. It's a really small image to color, so it's hard to like really get a ton of shading on it, you know? But I'm gonna add a little more black right under his, where his head is. Right there. There we go. I think that's pretty good. All right, we'll come over to the cat. And I'm going to very sparingly add a little bit of black on the edges to get a little bit of the shading. And then I'm going to add the black stripes because my kitties are tabby cats. So we're mostly just getting the main shaded areas. And then I'm gonna come back in with the stripes. Dabbing off my brush and then coming in to soften the shading. All right. We're probably safe to do the shading on the bunny. So I'm using some vintage photo. And the way I like to do bunnies when I paint with these colors is I'll do mostly the scattered straw over the whole bunny like I did here. And then just really sparingly where they're supposed to be shadow, I'll add the vintage photo. And it just allows the bunny to still kind of look yellow and, you know, have a glowing property to it. But you also get a little bit of that warmth from the vintage photo. I just think it looks really great. It's one of my favorite combinations when it comes to painting little animals. Scattered straw and vintage photo. He's got a lot of shading on him because he's a little guy all nestled in. This reminds me, I forgot to do the shading on the bear's paws. So we're going to go back to the ground espresso and add the shading on the paws. So we'll have some shadow right there and kind of down the side. And then over here. Oh, so cute. All right, so now I think the only thing we have left to do is add the stripes on the kitties. I'm gonna hit this with my heat tool. Oh, and the bird on top, I forgot. I'm using original distress inks today. I saw someone ask if it was oxides. It is not oxides today. All right, I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna just use a little bit of Rusty Hinge, actually. I'm just gonna add, actually, I'm gonna use the vintage photo. A little bit of vintage photo on this bird and it'll kind of soften the really, really bright properties of the bird. I think it will anyway. I should have made it blue. Missed opportunity. Okay. More vintage photo just to really kind of soften that bright, bright yellow. All right, I'm going to give its beak an orange color, but I'm going to wait until it has a minute to dry. Instead, I'm going to come down and grab more black soot and do the little stripes on the kitty. And I've discovered when it comes to little cartoon cats like this, less is better. So three little stripes there. Get some down the back. Now some on the little arms and then the tail. Oh, so cute. Oh, it needs stripes on its face too. Oh, what a cute little tabby cat. Okay. I'm gonna hit the bird with my heat tool. And then bring in some of that orange that I used on the penguin. And just put that right there. I don't know how much it's gonna show, but I guess I could do this little bird blue if I wanted to, right? But I think I'm gonna keep it just like this. I like how this looks. Let's zoom out a little bit so you can see the full image. Oh, they are so cute. I love them. All right, I'm noticing there's just one little spot here that's bugging me. Right there, finish up that ear. And then, is that all I want to change? Yeah. All right, I'm gonna take a minute and put away all of these colors before I, that one right there. I have them like in a specific order in my little tray. Okay, Dusty Concord, Shaded Lilac, Vintage Photo, Rusty Hinge, and Mustard Seed. Okay, I'll set those colors aside. And then I get to clean up my palette. I'm gonna set my project aside so it's safe. And then just use a spray bottle to add some water. And then just clean up the palette. I'm gonna get another paper towel and do more spraying. Decided not to use the other bird. I stamped it just in case, but I decided not to use it. All right, clean up that area. Okay, we are all good to continue. So I'm gonna die cut this, and I need to get my dies ready using these little snippers from Lawn Fawn. All right, I'm also gonna like take off these little sharp edges over a trash can. My whole arm is like in the trash can. Do that for this die as well. Even though I'm not using this little tiny guy for the bird, I'm not using him today, but that's okay. All right, so we're gonna die cut this, and then I'm gonna figure out what I want to do for like how the rest of the card looks. Mama Elephant always has these cute little elephant little tabs. Let's break that off. Going to use my Anna Griffin Mini Empress machine. Actually, no. Yeah, no, I'm not, because this paper's too wide. I'll use my original Anna Griffin Empress. Or I don't know if it's original. I think they may have come out with the mini and the regular size at the same time, but all right. just die cut these. Oh my word, even has the little mouse's tail in the die cut area. So cute. Just getting that centered the best that I can. And then I'll run this through my die cutting machine. So I'm thinking, okay, let's see here. On a card front, how big is that? Let's see. I'm going to pull out a regular A2 card. That's a really big image. Oh, it's perfectly sized. Okay. So if I put it near the bottom, and then I'm going to have my little die cut greeting or something. I could have it like up there, or I could even have it down below them. I'm just like trying to design my card, like exactly how I want to do this, you know? Also, the stamps have some really cute greetings that are like under, you could put like parrot. And I love this. I can't wait to hug you in person. I think that's just so cute. So I know I'm going to have a secondary greeting on here somewhere. So I could do like huge hugs, have that kind of more near the top, and then have this can't wait to hug you in person right below. Kind of leaves this area up here. I could have it be like the animals overlap the greeting and then can't wait to hug you in person. That could be really cute. Have it as a landscape card. That could be really cute. And then if I wanted to do that other bird, I could have it like somewhere up here. I don't think I want to. Or I don't use that greeting at all and I pair it with something else. Or I could just keep it simple and just have it be just the animals and have like just a, have it be right in the center. I love that because I love the image so much. I don't think it needs a ton with it. You know what I'm saying? So I put that can't wait to hug you in person up there in that top corner. I mean, the huge hugs, the huge hugs greeting is huge. I just don't know where to put it, you know? Okay, what if I could move to a 5x7 card. Let's try that. Okay, we go to 5x7. I have a huge hugs right there. Oh, I kind of like that. Keeps it a little bit more in line. And then can't wait to hug you in person. Oh, that could be kind of cute. And I kind of like the idea of maybe not even using the die, but just have it be stamped. In fact, it could be stamped and then the little fox's ear could kind of go over the top a little bit or even go like that. Oh, that could work. I like that. Okay, we're doing that. I just had to go to a larger card size. All right, I'm going to stamp directly onto the front of this 5x7 card. So I'm going to get the spacing just right and then I can put my stamp onto the door of my MISTI. Okay, so we want it a little bit like about like that. And I like it kind of tilted a little. In fact, you know what? No, we'll stamp the other secondary greeting separate. Okay, I'm going to use the same Versafine black Onyx ink. When I do like colored images like this, I don't tend to do a whole lot on the background of the card because I just love the image so much. I don't want to like detract away from it, you know, or distract from it. All right, I'm gonna stamp that one more time just to get a really solid image. I think I need to re-ink my Versafine pad. Much better. Looking at the comments, die cut the huge hugs hole on the top. Put the word on the inside. I don't know what you're describing. Okay. So let's figure out that secondary greeting. Because they're gonna go like right there. And then I can't wait to hug you in person. It's going to go maybe I want to have it on a banner coming out from behind the animals. I like that idea. All right. I think I'm just gonna use black cardstock. I always love a really good, like, black sentiment strip, you know? All right. There's some Hero Arts Pitch Black. And I'm going to use my anti-static powder tool. Get that up there in that corner. And then I probably should have figured this out before I did the anti-static powder tool. That's okay. I'm going to use Versamark ink. And white embossing powder. Just dip that in. Thank you so much, Cindy. You're so sweet. Thank you. Alright. And I'm going to use my little itty bitty paper trimmer. Cut off this end. There we go. Sorry, just putting some stuff away. All right, so back to the card. So then this can come out from right there. I'm gonna give the end of this just some a little ribbon end. So I'm gonna come in from the center, cut a little notch, and then come up from the corners up to that center. Okay, I think I can probably cut off about that much. And then when I come in, I can just put them in, just put it in just like that. Oh, that's gonna be so cute. Okay, someone in the chat mentioned you could like ink blend from behind the little critters. I kind of like that idea, and I feel like it does need something. Maybe even just like a really simple like stenciled pattern or something. Let's see here. I'm thinking. Stencils. Do I have all my stencils here? I may have sent my stencils with Angel Casey to look for discontinued ones. I didn't. I still have them. Yay. Okay. I'm looking through my stencil stash just to kind of find something that I think would work well to go right behind those animals. So I'm just looking through them. I want something really simple. I don't want anything like crazy. So maybe just like a repeating pattern of some sort, polka dots or stripes or even like diagonal stripes I think could work. Or if it's like hearts, like small repeating hearts. I'm liking that idea. All right, I'm just going through my stencils, seeing if I can find anything. I'm gonna even do stencils. Maybe I want to do like an embossing folder or something. No. Yeah. Okay, I'm not finding anything right off the bat, but I have not looked through all of them yet. All right, I found some dots that might work. But you guys know me, I use dots all the time. So I'm trying to branch out. Okay. I'm thinking I'm going to use these hearts. I think they could be really cute. These hearts, and you would just see a little bit of the heart around it. Okay. Okay, what color? I'm thinking blues. Like maybe like a nice aqua blue. Let's see here. My heat tool doesn't want to stay where it's supposed to stay. I like those hearts because they almost look like polka dots, but not really. All right, let's use like a Concord and Ninth sea glass, maybe. Yeah, I think that color could be really, really cute. I'm gonna grab a blending brush, like a nice soft one. So I can get really, really soft color, and then I'm going to use the stencil and go over it. All right. And we want it to come right from the center, like right this area right here. So where's my little blue paw print? It's gone. I've moved it. Oh, no, it's right there. Just like to have it hold my ink pad. Okay, and I'm going, normally when I blend from up here and I go like that. I'm going to use the handle because I think you get a little bit of a softer, in fact, I'm going to do this just so I can test it. Yeah, perfect. Okay, so just like, because I want it to be a really, really soft color. And then when I go over it with the hearts, I can have it be a little bit more intense. I'm also going to double check. I've got to get it out quite a bit more out from that center. More. All Someone in the chat's asking about the deadline for mail call cards. Mainly, I think if you were to send something for March, like try to get it in the mail by the end of March so that when I go to pick up my mail a few days into April, then your card would be there. Does that make sense? So like just try to send it in by the end of the month of the theme you're working on. Okay, let's test this. Okay, we need it just a little more over here and a little more over here. We need to go a little bit to this side, a little bit over to this side. Okay, how's that looking? Pretty good. So now I'm going to come in with, oh, Vinny, I'm definitely popping up the animals. They're going to be on foam tape. No worries about that. Put this right over the top. And then I'm just going to tape the stencil to the card from the back. I guess I could from the front too. In fact, I might. Let's do that. We'll do it from the front too, over on that side, just to hold things in place. And then I'm gonna switch to my handhold on the brush itself. Then I can start getting deeper color. And I don't know how much of the heart pattern will really show, you know, outside of the critters, but we'll see. I'm gonna lift this a little bit. Oh, so cute. Okay, yeah, that might be enough. Oh yeah, you can't really tell at their hearts. So crazy. Let's do a little bit more. Just so we can really see that their hearts, you know? Let's just go a little bit beyond the initial blending. Oh, my stencil moved. Move back, stencil. There we go. Okay. Yeah, now we can see more of it. Okay, yeah, I think that's gonna work a little better. So, where'd the critters go? Oh, there they are. Oh, I like that. That's gonna be really cute. I feel like I need to like extend the hearts out all the way to the rest. Like just, but I think I won't. I'll leave it. Yeah, that's gonna be really cute. All right, time to assemble. I'm gonna put this one on some foam tape. I'm at the very tail end of my little foam tape roll here. And then I'm going to put just one layer of, well, let's see here. We want it about like that. And then we'll put these little guys right there. How cute are they? I feel like this needs to move over just a little bit. There we go. All right. All right, so I'm going to put the foam everywhere, but right behind on that end. So in fact, I think I'm going to cut a thinner strip to go like right below. Okay, yeah, and then right about right there. I would just pop it up on two layers of foam, but I want to make sure I can send this in the mail. And I think two layers of foam tape generally are pretty safe, but I just don't want to have any issue, you know, with it not fitting into an envelope or not being thicker than a quarter inch. I'm going to put a little bit of liquid glue just right there. That'll go right onto that black piece. And then I'll just get this on here just like that. Oh, I've got some foam that's too... There we go. Oh, so cute. I almost want to like put a little die cut heart right there, but maybe, or maybe even right there. I'm trying to decide. Am I done? I might be done. I feel like this side needs to just... Okay. Yeah, I'm going to do that. Hold on. Just had an idea to fix some spacing issues that I was like feeling that I'm like, I don't know about that. Okay. So I'm just like cutting it down a little. Cut it down, and then well, do I want to just put it on a black card base? I could totally put it on a black card base. No, I think black's gonna be a little too harsh. Let's put it on a craft colored base. Kind of like that a little bit better. And then I'm also going to cut it down a little bit so it can be exactly centered. So put some foam adhesive, or not foam adhesive, but regular tape runner. On the back. I'll get this kind of centered up near the top. And then I'm just going to take a little bit off this end so that it's centered perfectly. I need to take like another little sliver off. Almost had it perfect. Okay, close enough. All right, so it's just a little bit shorter than 5 inches tall. Yeah, the craft color looks really good. I think it lends itself to the warmth of the image. I think it looks really great. So that's the card. Yay, I just have to clean my stencil when I'm done here. And we'll be all good. All right, there's our cutie little card. Are we ready to draw a winner for the giveaway package? I'm gonna do a little spiel for those watching the edited replay, and then we will draw a winner. Yay, okay. So here's my finished card for today. I love how it turned out, especially when I didn't entirely know how it was going to come together all in the end, but I like how it worked out. And I love that with the kind of more bright purple, you've got a little bit of a brighter kind of aqua shade, kind of goes with that. And then the warmth of the card base along with the bear and the fox, I think looks really great. Thanks so much for joining me today. I'll be back soon with another video. And until then, happy crafting, and I'll see you guys next time. Okay. Let's pick a winner. Hi. Hello again. All right, let's pick a winner. So we have only 275 of you enter the giveaway. I'm going to give you a little more time to enter the giveaway because there's 438 of you here now. And the giveaway is for a prize pack of Mama Elephant products, including the stamp set I used today and the dies I used today. Those will be included in the package as well as some other things. So if you have not entered the giveaway yet, go enter right now. You have a chance to win. And there's only 280 of you who have entered the giveaway so far. So you have a really good chance. So I'm going to just sit here and chat for a moment. You know, take a drink of water. Let those entries come in. Because some of you probably came in after I talked about it. So I'm going to let you go. Enter the giveaway. I'm going to hang out for a few minutes. If you guys have questions, this would be a good time to ask them. Petra, the perfect card with diabetes warning. It's sugar overload of cuteness. They are really, really cute, aren't they? All right. I'm going to scroll up to see if I have any questions that I've missed. And then if you have a question, put it in now. I'm going to draw the winner in just a minute. All right. My husband just walked through my craft room and he's like, do you want to hug me in person?
You couldn't wait.
You know, because I can't wait to hug you in person. Okay. Mm-hmm. He's been watching the live apparently. I don't see any questions right off the bat. But okay, I'm going to scroll back down to the end of the comments. Where can I get the brushes you used today? They're available over at simonsstamp.com. I'm trying to think what other sites carry them. I want to say Amazon has them too, but they're Royal and Langnickel Zen brushes. So if you just look up like Zen brush at simonsstamp, they'll all pop up. And they're really inexpensive, but they're good brushes, you know, and I think they look really nice. The Stencil 2 class that was just announced today, it starts on the 13th and it has 2 weeks of lessons, and then you'll have another week to do homework, and then we'll wrap up class. So the main portion of class is the last 2 weeks, kind of the mid 2 weeks of March, starting on the 13th. Jen B asks, how long have you been painting? The first time I started watercolor painting was in high school, and then I didn't really paint much until my senior year of college, when I had to take a watercolor class for my major, because I was an art major. So I took a watercolor class my senior year, and I wish I would have done it earlier because I loved it so much. After I graduated, I didn't watercolor for a while, and then I picked up watercoloring again, I think back in 2013. So it's been about 10 years when I've been consistently painting on cards. Have I ever been on craft roulette? I don't think I have, no. All right, giveaways are at 325.
So there's still like 100 of you who have not entered the giveaway. So if you want to enter the giveaway, now is your chance. It's just your name and your email, and I delete everything after the fact. So you know, there's nothing there. Terry's asking, what was the name of the palette you used to smush the inks on? Where would I get it? The palette that I use all the time is from Art Impressions. Alter New sells a palette, but really you could use anything. You could use the back of your stamp packaging, just anything that's a slick surface. So if you have a Ziploc bag, you could use a dinner plate, you could anything. The palette I have has been really nice because it's like a dedicated palette for this, and I can just, you know, save it in my craft room and pull it out when I need it. But to be honest, you could use anything that's a slick surface. So yeah. Why is Mina Maid saying sad? Sad what? I don't know. Let's see here. Barbara says, work, do you have more info to sign up for Stencil 2? Go to the link down the video description. It'll go straight over to online card classes, and you can read more about the class on that page. There's also a trailer you can watch to get some sneak peeks of some projects. Carrie's asking if I finished the organization of my craft room. No, it took a big, long 2-week pause when I was sick. And Angel Casey came by on Tuesday night and we did some more organization. I wish I could show you all. You're all going to love it. Like changing up some systems of how like I bring in new product and use it and things like that. So that'll be soon. I'm really hoping that like, because she's going to come by in the next week and we're going to try to really, I mean, it's a whole process. It's going to be an ongoing process, but I'm hoping to get it to the point where everything's put away, like everything's in cabinets. Right now, things are still out because we're figuring out where they're going, but I'm hoping to get everything put away and like surfaces clean and stuff like that, and then I'll do another update video. And I'm thinking I might do some like shorter mini videos that are diving into specific organization systems that I'm using, like how I organize cardstock, how I organize stamps and dies, how I organize watercolor supplies and paints and things like that. I'm thinking to do smaller videos for that because, I mean, some people on YouTube, they do a full in-depth craft room tour and they include all of that. But a lot of times people don't want to get really into it that deep unless they're interested about that particular area. So I'm going to do a broad overview and then I'll go in and do the more detailed stuff. That's the plan. I think it's going to probably be like a whole week long series or something. What ink did I use to stamp? I used a Versafine Onyx Black. Oh, she said sad because I'm not on Craft Roulette. Got it. Do you do any other crafts apart from card making? Yes, I do sewn felt little stuffies and ornaments. Just a side hobby. okay, let's do the giveaway. We are up to 343 entries. I'm going to go over to random.org, 343. Put that in. The winner, someone who got here quick. The winner is number 9. Number 9 is, so someone who was right here at the start. Number 9, Julianna Weiss. She has a Gmail email account. I just want to make sure, I don't want to give her email account away, but just so she knows that's, you know, this is her. So Julianna, if you are, or Juliana, I'm not trying to say it. If you're in the chat, you just won the giveaway. Let us know if you're here so we can congratulate you. And I will email you and then you'll just have to reply back with your mailing address and I'll get my little mom elephant prize pack mailed out to you. So Juliana, Juliana. In fact, you know, I could probably copy and paste this into the chat. Okay, yeah, that's her name. So I hope she's still here. Everyone's congratulating you. Make sure you guys come back next week for another live stream. I will have another giveaway for whatever products I'm using. So hopefully you can join in. And if I don't give away the products I'm using, because sometimes if it's Simon Says Stamp, I need to keep those in my craft room, I'll probably do a mail art or something, and then someone could win an envelope. So I hope, let's see, has she said, she's here yet or not? I have no clue. Last week, the winner, I emailed her and she's like, oh my gosh, like, I guess she was at work and she had to answer a phone call, and so she missed it when her name was drawn. Oh, there you are. There's Julianna. She missed it. The person last week, she missed it. And she's like, and I came back and everyone was congratulating me. And I was like, what happened? So anyway, so glad you're here in the chat. I will email you and we'll get that out to you as soon as we can. Thank you to everyone who joined me today. I'll be back hopefully next week. I'm pretty much over my sickness. You'd never know because I didn't put any makeup on today and I don't look quite alive yet. But I'm pretty much over my sickness, and so I'll probably be back to regular card schedule, you know, three videos a week. So I will see you all next week in person, and until then, I'll have some videos in between. Thanks for joining me, and I will see you guys next time.